Today's recipe is khada masala chicken. By khada masala chicken, I mean I will be using whole spices for this recipe. So here I've got onions. All the measurements will appear on the screen as well as it will be mentioned in the description box below. Here I've chopped onions finely. I've chopped some tomato and made it into a puree. Here I've got whole red chili, whole green chilies. These are amazing green chilies. Here I've got some poppy seeds. Now if you want to use this, you can use it, otherwise you can skip it. Poppy seeds is also known as khashkhash. Here I've got melon seeds, also known as char magas. So if you don't have melon seeds and poppy seeds, then you can skip these two. Here I've got some freshly made ginger paste, fresh garlic paste. Here I've got black cardamom, one cinnamon stick, green cardamom, bay leaf, aniseed, also known as badiyan ka phool. Here I've got javitri, also known as mace, and I will be freshly grating this nutmeg. I'll probably grate around quarter teaspoon to half teaspoon. Plus, here I've got some fennel seeds, also known as sauf, dhania seeds, known as coriander seeds. Here I've got cumin seeds, zira seeds, and some peppercorns. So what I'll be doing is I will be making a potli of this, these four ingredients, and I will be tying it in a mustard cloth and then adding it to my dish. Here I've got some salt as per taste. Here I've got red chili powder. This is Kashmiri red chili powder. This will just add color to this dish. Here I've got some haldi turmeric powder and some yogurt. Plus I've got here some garam masala powder. This is what we need for this recipe, and we also need chicken. Here I've got a kilo of chicken. You can take anywhere between 800 grams to a kilo of chicken. I've had it cut into 8 pieces and skin removed. Also, you can see I've washed this chicken well with room temperature water, and I've also applied a lot of turmeric haldi powder. This is just to remove the smell of the chicken. And what I'll be doing now is I'll again give it a rinse once more and just remove the excess haldi powder from this chicken. I will be adding these whole spices to this cloth. If you have a mustard cloth or a cheese cloth, it will work best. So what I'll do is I'll just pour it in this. Now why I'm using a cheese cloth or a mustard cloth is because I don't want these spices to be directly used in the dish. I just want the flavors to be infused in the dish. So what I'll do is I'll tie a knot. Just gather it all around and tie a knot. Now if you cannot tie a knot properly with your cheesecloth, that's fine. You can use a twine as well just to secure it. Probably I'll do that as well, just because I don't want any of these spices coming out from this cloth. This is our potli, which is ready to use. To a warm wok, just add some cooking oil. Here I'll be using approximately 1/4 cup of cooking oil. That's around 4 tablespoons. So I'll wait for this oil to warm up before adding my onions. Now my oil is warm, I'll just add in my onions. Give it a good stir. And we will fry these onions till they are transparent or translucent. Onions look translucent or transparent. Now at this point of time, I'll add in my cinnamon stick, black cardamom, green cardamoms, bay leaves, also known as tejpatta, aniseed, mace or javitri, and I'll give it a good stir. I'll let this saute for at least 30 seconds before adding my other ingredients. Now I'll add in some nutmeg, just freshly grated nutmeg. It's around 1/4 teaspoon. Give it a good stir again. While my onions are frying, I will be making a paste of these melon seeds, also known as char magas. So I'll be adding it to my chopper. And I will also be adding the poppy seeds. I want to make it into a nice paste. And I'll just be adding water, about 2 tablespoons to 4 tablespoons. And I'm going to make this into a puree. This paste is ready to use for my recipe. Now add the poppy seed, that's kashkash, plus the melon seed paste, also known as char magas. I'm just adding that. Give it a good stir. At this time, I will also be adding my red chilies. After 2 minutes of letting the char magas paste or melon seed paste cook with the onions, now I'll add in my garlic paste as well as my ginger paste. Give it a good stir. I'll also add in my turmeric powder. And let this saute for another 2 to 3 minutes. I'll also be adding some salt. Give it a good stir. Now you can see the oil is floating over the surface of the onions. At this point of time, I will add my chicken. Saute it well and let this chicken cook till the oil begins to float, by which I mean the original water from this chicken should dry out before adding the other ingredients to this recipe. While the chicken water is drying out, just introduce your poultry as well. If you have a smaller muslin cloth or cheesecloth, that would work better. I didn't have a smaller one. I know I could have cut this cloth into half, but I didn't want to do it. But if you have a smaller one, I think that would work best. The original water from this chicken has dried out. You can see that the oil is floating here around the surface on this side. That means I can add my other ingredients. At this point of time, I will be adding my tomato puree as well as Kashmiri red chili powder. Give it a good stir. Cook these tomatoes till the oil begins to float on the surface. Just mix everything well. Now if you want, you can cut the chicken into smaller pieces. Here I've just cut one chicken into 8 pieces, but you can most certainly have it cut into 10 or 12 pieces. It's up to you. Now we'll wait for these tomatoes to cook. The oil has begun to float over here after adding the tomato. It's taken exactly 10 minutes. Now I'll add in my whisked yogurt. And give it a quick stir. You need to be quick because you don't want the yogurt splitting. With high heat, the yogurt can split. Just give it a quick stir. And we let this also cook for at least 5 to 10 minutes. It's been exactly 5 minutes since I added the yogurt. Now I'll just give it a quick stir. You can see the oil has appeared over the surface here. Just give it a quick stir. And now at this point of time, I'll add in water. Here I'm adding in approximately 1.5 cups of water. And if I need more, I'll add in more later. And I'm also adding in 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder. If you want, you can add more or less depending on your choice, on your taste. Give it a good stir. You can see my potri is still here. I'll also add in my whole green chilies. And towards the end of my recipe, I will be adding my final ingredient, that's the garam masala powder. So now I'll just wait till the curry begins to boil. Now if you want, you can keep this as dry chicken, garam masala chicken, but I like gravy a little in my chicken, so I've added water. And I will be covering this chicken, cooking it on low flame till the chicken is completely cooked. Let's check if this garam masala chicken is ready. This garam masala chicken looks cooked. You can see the oil has come to the surface. Just give it a good stir. I'm going to check if the chicken is also cooked. So at this point of time, you can add in your garam masala powder. Give it a quick stir. I'll also check if the chicken is cooked well. Just take this, put my knife through. You can see it's going through easily, which means this chicken is cooked. Now, at this point of time, I will look for the potli, the muslin cloth which I added for the whole spices. I think this is the one, yeah. What I'll do is I'll just remove it from this gravy and try to squeeze the water out from it. So whatever the flavors, remaining flavors are in this potli, it will come out. Remember, this is very hot, so please do not touch this potli. At this point of time, please check for the salt, if the salt is good enough for this recipe. And I will finally garnish it with some cilantro leaves. If you have coriander leaves, you can use coriander leaves. If you have mint leaves, you can use mint leaves. It's up to you, whatever you like to use. And this is my garam masala chicken, which is ready to serve. You can enjoy this chicken with zeera rice or naans, even pav. I'll leave the links for all these recipes in my description box below. Garam masala chicken is ready to serve. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Please click on the bell icon for notification of my latest videos. And thank you for watching. Enjoy!